There are so many in-demand entry-level tech jobs that are coming onto the scene. And in today's video, I'm going to share with you what these roles are, what they are paying, and what skills are really required. Oh, and also too, what other courses you should be taking to get these skills. I did a lot of research for this video for the main reason of I am, as you know, fascinated with what is coming up, especially, can you believe that 2024 is like 8 weeks away? How did that happen? We need to be focusing on what do we want to be looking for in the new year when it comes to our roles, our careers, and this will help guide you. On the note of upskilling, I want to say a huge thank you to Codecademy who sponsored this video, and even more so is giving back to you. They are offering, listen closely here, they are offering 1 month free of Codecademy Pro for the first 300 people who use the link in my description. So go sign up today because you need to level up for 2024. We are taking our careers to the next level, and by learning online through the comfort of your home, I mean, that's a win-win if you ask me. All right, let's get into it. Coming in at number 10 is web developer. And this is a great place to start your career if you are someone who is leaning to more of the technical side versus going into the product management side or soft skill side. I think this is such a great place to start your career because it will teach you so much about the foundations when it comes to development that you can then take it and go in so many different directions, whether it be software engineering, whether it be more front-end or UI UX design. It really can help you set that foundation to branch off into different directions. Now, I always refer to levels FYI for compensation, and it's because it is accurate. What it does is it actually surveys people from different companies and then double checks that as to what you should expect. Now, this is the median compensation, so this isn't just for juniors, this is the middle ground. And we're not talking about location here because you are located everywhere throughout the world, but it does give you a sense as to what you can expect. Now, the medium is median, that's such a hard word to say, by the way, is 148,000 US. Obviously, when you are starting out in a junior role, this is not what you will be getting, but it is a great indicator as to what you can work towards. Coming in at number 9 is UI and UX researcher. This individual wears a lot of different hats and is something that I would fail at brutally, by the way, because of what it really entails, which is a lot of, how would you say it? You're really thinking not only about the design, but you're also thinking about the, of course, the user experience. And I feel like I'm terrible at that. The fact that I can get dressed in the morning is a task on its own. No, I'm just kidding. But UI and UX design. So what are some concepts within that? One is behavioral research or conducting behavioral studies. So user groups, focus groups. Another big aspect is accessibility. Are the designs you are creating accessible to everyone online? Levels FYI is they have 169,000 for their median salary, or total comp, I should say. And this is really interesting because of course it's not an entry level accuracy, but it is something to start working towards. And honestly, I didn't realize that UI and UX researchers could make so much. I kind of thought it was, yeah, I didn't know the compensation was so high, but I've researched not only on Levels FYI, but other resources, and that is accurate. Coming in at number 8 is junior cybersecurity specialist. And I think I've spoken about cybersecurity and how great of a role or great of a field it really is to get into. And as AI continues to dominate the tech industry, more and more cybersecurity specialists are going to be needed. But here's a question that I asked myself the other day. What exactly does a cybersecurity specialist do? Like, what are 3 main points of responsibility? All right, here you go. Take notes on this. So point 1 being analyzing network structures and testing security measures such as software permissions and firewalls. Number 2 being ensuring the company data remains secure by protecting it from cyber attacks. And this is done through various different ways, which I'll share with you in a second here. And then the number 3 thing would be designing and implementing data recovery plans in case of cyber attacks. So not only are you ensuring the data remains secure, but you're also preparing and designing data recovery plans. So there is a lot of responsibilities. Cybersecurity, even if it might not be the position you want to get into, maybe you want to get into the web developer role or a product manager role, you will need, it's across the board though, that cybersecurity knowledge is essential, and it's continuing to just go up, skyrocket in that direction. All right, cybersecurity money. Let's talk money. What can you expect? All right, for this one, it was not on Levels FYI, so I went to Glassdoor. That is such a tongue twister, by the way. Cybersecurity specialist make. All right, let's see what it says. for a junior role, it starts off around 82,000 US. And that sounds pretty accurate if you ask me. We are talking entry-level role. You are going to be making a pretty good salary entering into the tech industry. Coming in at number 7 is product manager. And for a long time, I thought you had to have years of experience before getting into product management, because that's typically the career path we used to see. Now though, I have seen so many people after they are graduating business school, computer science, depending on where they are at, but both technical and non-technical, go straight into product management roles. Entry-level product managers are oftentimes shadowing more senior-level product managers that are more experienced, and they are maybe taking on not as many tasks or big projects or products on their own, but rather helping out with their large or more senior, more senior product manager. And oftentimes they are crucial in guiding and leading the team to success when building out a product. Now, product managers can make bank. They can make quite a bit of money, and so much so that Levels FYI is stating the median comp to be 195,000 US. We're starting out with way less than that for entry levels. We're starting out below the hundreds for entry levels, the reality is, but it is a good number to start working towards. Next up, let's go to one that doesn't require necessarily getting into the code as much per se, which is tech sales engineer. And yes, some of these tech sales engineers might be building and creating demos for their clients or solving problems as they are selling the product itself. But a lot of tech sales engineers, it doesn't mean coding on a day-to-day basis, but rather understanding the technology. Now, for a course I would take on Codecademy for tech sales engineer, I'd probably start out with a basic level coding course or an introduction to coding. It can really vary based on the company you work for, but even more so aside from that, because once again, coding is not necessarily required, but that understanding of coding or how the tech works is really required. So it really varies based on company. Okay, also too quickly for salary, can't forget the salary or compensation. They didn't have this on Levels FYI, so I went to a company called Zipia, and they are estimating around 88,000. I have to keep in mind, with sales, they oftentimes will get a lower base salary, and this might not necessarily, I'm guessing the base salary for someone who's entry level will be even lower than what I just said, for the reason of sales oftentimes have large bonuses and really work on what deals they are able to close that will affect their bonuses. Also, I don't think you can, but there's a full-on marathon going on outside my window. So if you hear any like cowbells, it's because they're cheering people on. Can you hear it? I'm hoping not, but there you go. Coming in at, what number are we coming in at? Number 5. We're coming in at number 5. Coming in at number 5 is junior iOS developer. We don't hear a ton about iOS developers as much, I think, as we used to, which is interesting. And I think the reason is because a lot of us right now, well, I don't really know why, but it's still very in demand. When I was doing research as far as how the industry is hiring for it, where it is at, it is continuing to rise up and up. Up, up, up. Now, because this role is still so in demand, the salary reflects that. 182,000 is a median comp for iOS salary. And one of the thing is, this salary, I think, will continue to vary based on company, location, you know the drill, but it's definitely a number to work towards. You know this list would not be complete. I mean, we couldn't even do this list if I didn't list this next one, because it is still, I would say, the most trendiest job title. And I always get asked about it. You know what it is. What is it? Say it for me. Data scientist, of course. This is still such a trendy and, you know, rightfully so, it's still very in demand. I do see other roles though that we will talk about coming up, which might be taking the spot for number 1, but data science is still so in demand. We often hear this term, data scientist, but what does a data scientist even do? In simple terms, let's list off like 3 main or 3 key points. This is not 3, I don't know where this came from. Let's list off 3 main points. First one being data collecting and cleaning. So collecting, importing, and cleaning data to ensure accuracy, which is so important, completeness, and uniformity. Making sure essentially that this data is things that we can then actually lean on to. The next one is exploratory data analysis, or EDA. And this is conducting exploratory data analysis to understand the characteristics and distributions of the data. The third one being, let's visualize this data, data visualization. Conducting or creating visualizations to represent data trends, distributions, and relationships among the variables. Now, let's get to the good part, salary. I mean, that's why we all wanna be a data scientist, right? I'm just kidding. All right, Levels FYI, this is not necessarily entry level position, but let's go in with the median total comp in the US. And this is think of this as something to work towards, which is $160,000. I mean, that's great. That sounds like a nice number if you ask me. Coming in at number three is cloud computing. This is an area we've seen really burst into the scene quite a few years ago, I would say 3 to 4 years ago. Obviously it was around long before that, but that was really when it went from going up to all of a sudden like peaking, and everyone started realizing how important the cloud is. For entry level salaries for cloud computing roles, they didn't have it on Levels FYI, so I went on to ZipRecruiter, which is a recruiting company, and the entry level cloud computing salary in the US, I don't know if this is accurate, it says it's 118,000, yeah, that makes sense, 118,000 US per year. So this is a role, at entry level you can get in just below 100 or just above 100, which I mean, is great if you ask me. Coming in at number two is something that some of you might say is a mythical unicorn, or I guess unicorn on its own is mythical, so we don't need to say it's mythical. You get what I'm saying. A lot of people in the tech industry are like, this role isn't real. However, why is it coming at number two? Because it is one of the most in-demand jobs still, so it is real, but we just need to set our expectations accordingly. What do you think I'm talking about? This is full stack developer. Full stack developer, full stack engineer. You are someone who is not only able to build with the front end, but also build back end, and also understand system design. I mean, the list can go on as to your responsibilities. The one of the most in demand roles companies are hiring for, because a lot of companies don't have the funds to hire for both a front end and back end developer if they're starting out. So they're gonna pay even more money, but for one individual. All right, but it costs less to hire the one individual than two. You get what I'm saying. On Levels FYI, for median comp, the total is 149,000. Once again, not entry level, but something to work towards. And I've seen this salary go up way higher than this as well. Coming in at number one, you know what this entails. Number one is AI engineer. Of course it is. Of course it's something with AI right now. I mean, it would be inaccurate if it wasn't. AI is everywhere bursting onto the scene. And there are so many entry-level roles with AI that are available today. Because of how quickly it is moving, the roles or the people to fill these roles are not able to keep up. What does exactly an AI engineer do? Like, what does it really consist of? Here are three things. One is designing, developing, and optimizing machine learning models. Another is implementing AI solutions to meet the business needs. And number three would be working with data scientists and other stakeholders to ensure the AI solutions are implemented effectively. This role can vary greatly based on company to company, but those are three kind of good pillars to focus in on. Now, I went back to ZipRecruiter for this salary. For the entry level AI engineer salary, it's around 62,000 per year. And you might be saying, well, Tiff, why is this number one then if it's not the highest paying salary? Because it might not be number one in salary, but in demand as far as skills go and where the salary will go, it is number one. That's why I put it as number one. But at the end of the day, all of these roles have so much opportunity for you to really start your career in and just take off. We always talk about tech as an industry, which it is, but tech touches every industry and it's not going anywhere ever. This is probably, in my opinion, the most secure industry you can get into if you really want to grow and have a successful career. Now, maybe I'm biased because I work in tech, but I don't know, the data and the numbers are there.
Okay, hi friends, I'm coming to you from the future. Well, when you watch this, it will be the past. But I was going through this video and I realized I need to share with you some incredible resources to help you get these kind of roles, get into these positions. We talk a lot about what positions are in demand, what jobs are in demand, but how do you level up? How do you upskill to get into them? This is something when I was first learning to code, and even now working in the tech industry for almost 7 years, I still face where to go. Well, I know where to go, but upskilling is a forever thing. So I thought I'd share with you some courses on Codecademy that will help you level up, specifically one around full stack engineering, because that really can touch multiple roles with different facets of it. And then also to the other one around AI. Let's start with full stack engineering. Also too, fun fact, Codecademy was one of the first resources I used when I was learning to code. So shout out to Codecademy for helping me land my first job and then continue to level up. All right, on screen here, we have their full stack engineer course, and this will include JavaScript, Node, SQL, Express, React, test-driven development, and more. And one of my favorite things about not only this course, but a lot of different learning paths that they have to offer is that they offer a certification. You can put this on your resume that you have a certification in full stack engineering. Not to mention, it doesn't hurt that the salary that they have here for average salary is 120. Sounds pretty good to me. That's supposed to be a chef's kiss. You know what I mean. The emoji. All right, so this starts with from beginner and you will work your way down. So this is really incredible. They say time to complete is around 6 months and you can do this with zero prerequisites. If you are someone who wants to learn how to code, become a full stack developer, this course is for you. All right, the other one, because I came in at number one, we have to do something around AI engineer. This is something that I haven't actually started taking this course yet, but I think it'll be the next course I take, mainly because my next role will not be in AI engineering, but as a developer and someone who always likes to build. It's so relevant today, and I'm just really fascinated and curious about it. So I think this will be my next course I take. So if you're taking it, let me know in the comments. And this takes about 4 months to complete. Certification, check mark, yes, and prerequisites, none. So this is another amazing course. I really like how to, they are really focusing on trending technologies, Python, machine learning, they go into pandas, Git, Bash. It really covers the full spectrum. So when you're done this course, you feel really prepared to take on that next step in your career or go to apply to different jobs that you might want, whatever the case may be. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video and leave it feeling really inspired as to where your career can go, what roles maybe you're interested in that you didn't even know about or consider for yourself. Also too, if you're interested in leveling up with Codecademy, they are offering 1 month free for Codecademy Pro for the first few people who sign up with the link down below. So don't miss out, go sign up today and let me know what courses you end up taking. Thank you all, I'll see you soon.